Good work. It looks like YZ30 is also in our hands, which means we've got them surrounded and they're running out of options. We hold our fleets here and they'll have to surrender.
Why did that play before the cutscene bit?
Control, what's the situation back home? We've been out here for 3 days with no action and no readings. What the hell is HQ waiting for?
We hear you. It sounds like HQ is ready to advance on Tau City and wrap this up. I was hoping we could avoid another massacre, but stand by. We're patching something through to the fleet.
This is Sirius Station GV-518. We're detecting unknown vessels warping in just outside communication range. We can't get a read, but we don't have any transit scheduled until next week.
It's a pre-recorded signal from 40 minutes ago. We can't get a connection.
Send us in there. We'll see what's going on.
We're way ahead of you. Super Galaxy Squadron, break off from the fleet and make your way to Sirius. The Advance can't wait for you, but hopefully it's a false alarm and we can get you back on the front lines. Control out.
Obviously, it's not a false alarm. Alright. I guess we're just gonna do a different ship every level. Why not? So who looks coolest after that? I'm liking that rotatey thing. Ooh, flamethrowers! I didn't notice that before. There's so many good ships I can't pick. Not bad. Rotatey or flamethrowers? Yeah, we're gonna go with flamethrowers. Note to other shoot 'em up devs, make more cool ships! Oh man, I'm so slow, holy crap! I didn't notice his agility rating. I was just looking at how cool the weapons are, not the other stats, really. Certainly seems to do some damage, though. I think you do start with max power, so I guess that's why things feel underwhelming, because I'm just already at max power, so I'm not, you know, I'm not seeing them from level 1. I guess everything probably has a similar progression. Are these homing, or just in the same pattern every time? It feels like they're going the same pattern. Yeah, they are. They're not homing. Okay. Not everything- ow. Not everything needs homing, so that's fine. Maybe. It'd be kind of lame if everything had homing, right? Damn it. You know, homing kind of made that- the laser thing feel a bit better. Ooh, I love the spinny things. Because, I mean, the basic weapon was very straightforward, and then you have the homing, so you cover both bases, and this just has a wider area of effect in general, so it doesn't really need homing. Variety is good, kids. I feel that's something a lot of games don't offer quite enough of, is like meaningful variety. Like, a big thing I don't like in modern first-person shooters is that just it's all similar military weapons, and it's like first-person shooters in, you know, around, you know, late 90s stuff, everything was different. All the guns were different, every series had very different guns. It felt very good, and like, Ratchet & Clank still does that. It's not a first-person shooter, obviously. I guess the new Doom does that. I've been hearing very good things about the new Doom, except for the multiplayer. Parker, not now. Parker. Sit. Sit. Parker. Just sit. Come on. Please. Sorry. Obligatory Parker interruption number one. Tail! Get your tail out of the way! Parker, no. Don't do the thing. Yeah, just sit. Just sit, okay? Just, if you sit, there's no problems at all. I probably shouldn't be too much of a wuss about aw. I was expecting that to erase bullets. It didn't. My bad. I think only the first ones Super has actually erased bullets. Which, I mean, I guess they're all for killing bosses, not escaping bullets. This is a shoot 'em up, not a bullet hell. I guess I shouldn't expect smart bullet erasing bombs. Aw, crap, we're dead. Alright, I don't really like this ship too much. Actually, I'm not sure if it's this ship's fault, but we're still gonna switch anyway. plain old ship. Let's do this one. It's got lots of armor, very low agility again. Actually, maybe this is a mistake. Part of what I didn't like about that last ship was the low mobility. Whatever. This rotating thing is cool. I mean, it's basically not much different from just having a wide beam or just like a straightforward beam, but just a little nice bit of visual flair on top of the basics. And sometimes that's all it really takes, you know? It doesn't matter if it's like significantly gameplay differently, but just anything to give it just a little bit of visual, you know, something visually interesting about the ship's differences. I feel like I'm collecting Internet Explorer Legos. Just a little bit. I'm sorry to have planted that thought into your mind, because the game doesn't deserve Internet Explorer Legos, but just something about the big ones looks a little like that horrible E. That's fine. They're Internet Explorer Legos that charge my hyper, so I can forgive them. I can't tell what most of the- oh! It just buffs my attacks. For a bit. The hypers are a little less obvious than I thought they would be, at least... maybe it's just the game being so hectic that I can't really tell. But I'm not feeling the wow factor on some of these hypers like I was for the first one. But they don't erase bullets, so it's kind of hard to see them in action even. Also, best I can tell, even though this is arcade mode, oh, maybe it's because I didn't pick hardcore. I was expecting arcade mode meant I get kicked out if I die too many times. I don't think I have credits. I think you have to pick hardcore mode for that. I'm sure that was explained, and it's my fault for not reading it. Sorry, but yeah. Not like I'm really complaining about. Oh wait, these home. The missile's home. I just now finally noticed that, because they were getting stuck chasing one of those things. I do like this better than the flamethrower ship. The flamethrower ship had some good visual flair, and some good actual flair, I suppose, but the combo of homing lasers and just better range, I guess, and this just feels better somehow. But I mean, maybe that's just me not doing as poorly this time and I'm being biased, I don't know. Ah! I almost made it through. No! What's wrong with me? Whatever, you're going down. That was embarrassing. I was doing so well. I was feeling a little proud of myself, I'll be honest. And then that happened. That's why you never feel proud about yourself. I honestly expected to die before the end. And I mean, maybe it's just because I picked casual, but I guess I'm playing the whole thing. I'll still be up to stream this, though. But maybe after I stream some of the games that I don't actually get to the end to. Like, I recorded Prism... Refrain? Prism Memories or something? Sorry, I can't remember the exact title. But it was pretty fun, but I didn't get to the end of it. I would probably stream games like that where I, you know, didn't get to the end and I need more practice on before I stream this again. Not stream, but record. What hit me? But yeah, I'd definitely be down to stream this and some other games. Shoot 'em ups. Prototype beacon. I do like the different scales for the bosses, like that normal ship boss that turned into a robot. That was a good curveball. I was expecting the, you know, standard giant ship bosses. We've got sort of like slightly larger than normal ship bosses now too. Damn it! I feel really stupid when I take the multiple hits. The multiple hits, you know. Oop. Ah! I thought I was avoiding it. I was not. I think my hitbox is shown. It's that, you know, it's that purple dot. Every ship seems to have something kind of like that. What are you gonna do? I'm scared.
They're warping out of Sirius. They'll be trying to hit the core before we have a chance to prepare. Don't let them lose you. The advance on Tal Ceti is already underway, but we'll get you some backup however we can.
Story mid-boss fight? I'm so confused.
We're getting reports of Ceti arriving in Centauri. We need to pull our forces
back. Control, this is IFB Yukon in charge of the fleet at Tau Ceti. It was a goddamn trap. The system was empty and we've got squids flanking us from all sides.
IFB Yukon, can you send anyone back to the core to assist?
Sorry, but we're getting devastated out here. I think you're on your own.
Roger. Super Galaxy Squadron, I'm calling all Navy Reserve in the area to Centauri. Otherwise, it's all up to you. If we lose that system, this war is over. Whatever you have to do, don't let that happen. This is why you're here. Control out.
I might have to split this into two videos. I should have stopped at the 30-minute mark, but... oh. I love that we aren't just the one ship that just devastates everything in the entire galaxy. We are actually a team. It's like, it doesn't really matter, but it's still, it just feels so much more plausible and, like, reasonable somehow. Like, I mean, it's obviously not an important feature, but it's pretty cool how they handled the story. It, like, feels a lot more cohesive than, you know, most plain old shoot 'em ups without being obtrusive. Like, it's not exactly Uncharted over here with, you know, cutscenes and stuff. Well, not like, you know, significantly long ones. Also, pretty good music here. I hadn't really commented on before, but, it's probably my favorite music so far, but none of it's been bad. I should check out that Galaxy Squadron classic. I hadn't heard of this. It just showed up in Evolve PR's system, and I was like, hey, that's a shoot 'em up. It's funny, Evolve's PR system, they have a whole bunch of, like, AAA and, you know, bigger indie stuff, and I'm just looking for the small and the weird stuff. That's what I like. Stuff with good crunchy chiptunes. Big old pixels and lots of explosions, that's what I'm after. That and the weird stuff. Speaking of weird stuff, I have some weird stuff, some alt games. I need to get to that too. I'm not sure if that'll be forthcoming this week, but I do have some stuff to record. I just got so behind, I'll blame Uncharted 4. I played Uncharted 4 all this week. Absolutely fantastic game, you don't need me to tell you that. That's why I don't do reviews on AAA games. I don't really like the cinematic AAA angle very much. Naughty Dog absolutely nails it, though. They understand. They do it right. And it plays good, too. Like, just the feeling of exploring is great. But that's all I need to talk about Uncharted. Everybody knows about Uncharted. Oh, neat little planety zoom here. This makes me want to play a bunch of, like, oh, cool! Makes me want to play a bunch of, like, actual 16-bit shoot-em-ups. Like, I've got a bunch on my Wii. I'm not sure how to get them recorded best. I guess my Wii U in Wii mode? And, yeah, I guess that I could get pixel-perfect recording through that, I think. Or no, it'd be upscaled, but it'd be better than Wii on a non-CRT anyway. Wii mode is just so awkward, and it sucks because I can't have full... Like, a bunch of those shoot-em-ups aren't on Wii U Virtual Console, so I can't really... I can't show them in the more modern Virtual Console state. Not that the modern Virtual Console is actually very good. Like, the colors for N64 and NES games are terrible. I think SNES games are safe. But I actually more need the TurboGrafx-16 than the SNES. But yeah, I've got some cool stuff on there. Alien Soldier, Final Soldier. Wait, not Alien Soldier. I'm thinking of... Alien Soldier is that treasure game. I am thinking of Star Soldier. Crap. Star Soldier, is it Blazing Lasers? I've got a bunch. Yeah, this just reminded me that some of those I never beat. Oh yeah, Gate of Thunder, I think? Yeah, I've got a whole bunch of 16-bit shoot-em-ups on my Wii. I should show some of them off. I'm not sure anybody wants to buy Wii Virtual Console games anymore, and most of them aren't available elsewhere. But, when does obscurity ever stop me from recording something? Oops. I really do hope the NX, that they unscrew the Virtual Console. It is like their best asset, and is just criminally mismanaged. Ha! Cool! I like this, that's how you do a hyper mode. Yeah, I will say that most hyper modes are a little disappointing, especially next to this. Wait a minute, did I do something different there? There's no way that was just a normal hyper, right? No, I did some sort of overdrive. How did I get to super overdrive? I wasn't paying attention. I guess just because I had so much crap stored up. So I still don't understand all of the mysteries of this game, I guess. Oh, it's this guy! Beacon Mark II. You're not looking so good, buddy. Yeah. Of course, despite being torn apart, he's actually stronger and has more health because of video games. I thought that would erase bullets. Wait, it is erasing bullets. Sort of. I think it erased some bullets anyway. Oh man, this is going... It's going very badly. Oh man. Oh. That was disgraceful. This guy isn't very good for bosses, though. I can't rectify that either. You can't change ships. Until it's the start of the level. I was gonna switch to maybe the sword. Or no, the sword would actually be really bad because I can't get that close. But maybe the beam. Ah. Speaking of swords and shoot 'em ups, which sounds very strange, Gido Gotta Happa has a sword character that is like super powerful and like, and also a fist character that has, you have to be at the exact distance. Like your fists go a certain range and then explode. And if the enemy is in right exactly that range, you do crazy damage. It is really interesting and cool. Ah. Okay. My skills are finally failing me. I knew I was doing too well in a shoot 'em up in a, like, first play situation. Like, I knew that wouldn't last. But, damn it. Okay, so this one does erase bullets. I like this. I like the ship's hyper a lot. I also want to see that overdrive. How did that happen? I need to see it happen again. No, stop that! Damn it. There was health on screen. Oh man, this boss is hard. I'm gonna have to take a break on this one. Look how much score we have, though. Damn it! Ah. No. I guess he's dropping decent amounts of health. Ugh. The no invincibility frames is bugging me a bit here. With the lack of his invincibility frames. I didn't need that health, but seeing it disappear hurts, because I will need it. See? I swear it drops more health after you die. That has to be a thing that is happening. Because there's no way that it just happens to be dropping more. I don't mind accessibility features like that, but it hurts my pride just a little tiny bit. Oh god. Even though I obviously need it. No! Fuck. I'm trying to tone down the swears, but sometimes it's raw emotion. Let's see if I can charge up an overdrive. Okay, no, that's a bad idea. Don't wait for the overdrive. Just shoot. Getting hit twice in a row really makes me feel sad. I just have to mention that. I have a health system in a shoot 'em up, so I mean, I guess I shouldn't be complaining. You know, that's obviously more than one hit is more than I get in almost anything. But getting hit twice, ugh, I feel like I'm being wronged. Damn it! I went right into that and just took all of that damage. That was bad. Where's the health? Ah, health. Thank you. I honestly can't tell if it's giving me more health or not, because I mean, sometimes this time it doesn't feel like I'm overflowing with health. So maybe it's just a little random? Oh my god, are you kidding me? No! Would you please die? Would you please die? Seriously, die. Oh my goodness. That's not good for my heart. Okay. Okay. What is that? Are you kidding? I have the worst ship for bosses and you're doing... That isn't even my final form on me? Oh man, I'm never picking this ship again. Its hyper is actually really cool, it is a great ship, but all of its firepower is completely wasted on bosses. The plus side, I guess, is that I don't really have to aim. Or rather, it is impossible to aim. So, don't worry about it, I guess? It's both good and bad, I suppose. But I would feel way better with that laser dude right now. The forward laser. At least he erases bullets with his hyper, unlike half the cast. But I just feel like all of my damage output is being wasted. That sounded like some Final Fantasy battle music for a second there, before the loop reset. That's not a complaint, but it's just an observation. I don't even know how much health you have, bro. Is there some way I can fight just this ship with a different, or like just this level with a different ship? This weapon or this ship, it's not happening. I need the laser guy. I need the laser guy. Alright, I'll concede defeat if I die this time. And I'll try a different ship I'll finish the game, but I need a different ship. I do not think this ship is helping. See, this time it's not dropping all that health it was before. I don't know what's up with that. Now it's dropping health. Okay. Not too bad, not too bad. Aw, come on, come on! With the two hits! Whatever, we get fully healed before this anyway. I really want to see that overpower, or that overdrive against a big boss, but I probably shouldn't. I don't know how that triggered. It's not that I don't like this ship. This is a really great ship for trash mobs. This is not a final boss killing ship. This is just a normal ship that is not remotely appropriate for dealing, you know, single point damage, or like single target damage. Ow. I shouldn't be taking these hits. This is not really too hard to dodge. Everything is obviously my fault. Now this is a bit harder with all of the options alive, which I'll hopefully remedy soon. See, that's the bit... It sounds like a very specific part of Final Fantasy VIII's combat music, right before it does that re-loop. I do really love the patterns this boss is putting out, though. It's kicking my butt, but these are really good patterns. They're very dodgeable, too, despite me taking that hit there. See, I love these highways. I've always been a fan of those. Ah, I'm so dead. Ah, come on! Alright. I'm gonna stop the recording, and I'm gonna... Is it really just one volume meter? Come on. Wait, does this actually have rumble? No, leave that on. Have I been feeling rumble? I'm so used to games not having rumble on PC when they say they do. Yeah, it's not rumbling. Unless it only rumbles when you die, which would be stupid. Oh, it does! Okay, I have been feeling rumble. I'm so used to rumble not working, I don't even notice when it works on PC. It just... Wait, can I? Does this let me continue with the last level? No! Not this! Okay, a level select would be grand. Do I have... I have to... Oh, come on! How dare you lock me? Can I... It locked me to the ship that is the worst at doing this. Oh, whatever. It's the final battle. I guess I gotta do it. I wasn't expecting this to take more than a half hour, to be quite honest. I guess we're gonna go for the full hour. Stop taking so many hits! You know what? I'm sorry, I think I have to do this later. I think I'll do a second playthrough for fun, and then show you the final boss properly later. Maybe I'll make it up to you, like, I don't know if... Coming soon? Wait. Interesting. There's two different modes of Endless. I will do a video of me being the final boss, but I need to calm my nerves and do a second video. Well, not second. Third? Whatever. I need to do another video today. And I don't want to be playing this for like an hour. I mean, I don't disapprove of playing this game for an hour, but I disapprove of me recording me failing for an hour. But yeah, next time, final boss time, and Super Galaxy Squadron time.